godly freedom. My wife comes to me this at the beginning of a new year, God, lead me. I'm following you right where you are. We are the family. We all feel. Jesus, you're our Savior. You're the sweet lily of the valley. You're our bright and morning star. You're the bearer of 10,000. You're Emmanuel. You're God. You're us. You're the light of this world. The only hope for those lost in such darkness. We praise you for your mighty grace, Lord. Your mercy is to renew every morning, and your grace that meets us at every step of our journey. We thank you for another day, Lord, another week, another year. Thank you for another decade, Lord. We know that you've been with us. You've never left us. You've never forsaken us. We thank you that you're worthy of the Son of God, Lord. The righteous have run to it time and time again and found refuge and safety. We thank you, Lord God, for your promise to return one fine day, Lord. We say, even so, come, Lord Jesus. But until then, Lord, help us to act upon it. And help us to take it to the faith, Lord, to break all the power of doubt to the wicked one. Help us to wield the sword of your Spirit, Lord, the Word of God, to feed all the powers of the enemy. Help us to cast and pray to face, Lord, in a manner we've never done before. Help us to live with holy lives of concentration, separation from this world and all of its temptations, Lord. And Father God, we pray to you this morning. Bless your church in America, we pray, Lord. Church in all the churches, all the preachers and pastors that are unashamedly teaching the whole counsel of God. We don't fear or favor of man, Lord. Strengthen those who unapologetically speak the truth in love. May your heart reflect, Lord, your grace and your knowledge and your prosperity, Lord. May churches that speak your truth and proclaim your Bible grow, Lord, this year with souls and families and neighborhoods and entire cities. One for the name of Jesus Christ. Now, Lord, at this house, we're going to look to your word. We're going to show ourselves in the head of God. We're not interested for one moment in the opinions of man, Lord. But we do need a word from God. And we need us to hear what the Spirit says, Lord. Give us hearts, minds to understand it, and to embrace your truth. Give us hands to work it. Speak to run with your message, Lord. We pray all of this in the name that still is and always will be above every other name. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, come to such a time. Amen. And amen. Say amen again. Say yes, Lord. In Jesus' name, praise God. If you're watching online, you may hear online at revivealday.net/give. That's the word of Jesus. Carefully to pray to give to support this ministry and this church, and thank you for it. Can I ask you to pray this week and the next couple of weeks for my godly witness and testimony and patience? What did you want to pray for in the coming weeks for my godly patience and witness and Christian testimony that you normally do? Well, my wife and I will be pastors and preachers in the beginning of it. I have to deal with God's God, my Christian witness and presence. Now, thank God for the existence of this ethical health salesman. We need more of it. Is there a man? And then he's going to say, and Tom is one of my sons, one of my sons, was having a study with one of my sons as we kiss it down. I'll be honest with you, the only time in my adult life I ever really attempted to make some flights out was a place to he did not get that from me, or his mother, But sometimes the more that I could expand, as I feel the car salesman pray for my Christian witness, but I'm an anti-Christian and anti-Christian, you know? I think that's the best of my life. Thank you, Jesus, for being a part of you this week, because for repetition, let me go to the person. Interesting repetition is the most established way to learn. Interesting repetition is the most established way to learn. Interesting repetition. Let me just review for a few moments what we went over last week in preparation for this new year. 2020 vision for a prophetic new year. And as you know, I have that habit of looking to the Bible, the entire Bible, when it comes to certain dates and certain times. And I looked just before 2020, turned the calendar, I looked and I found words for us and words for me and words for you and words for us together. It says 2020, and 2020 says, keep my Sabbath day holy. After 2020, keep my Sabbath day holy. In other words, make Sunday a priority to worship God. Don't look at any excuse to miss Sunday, to miss church, but make it a priority to get to church. Acts 2020, and I think he knows about me from now. I never strayed back from telling you what you need to hear either publicly or in your homes. Social media, preaching, the gospel of Jesus Christ, I never strayed back from telling you what you need to hear, not what you want to hear. And let nobody know that you're not hearing what you want to hear, what you need to hear. Okay. That's just one of the 20 other cases. I still have to be strong because I thought that was actually easy to do. You might say that. That was the test of my faith. That's Ezekiel 20:20, keep my Sabbath day holy. Acts 20:20, I never strayed back. Exodus 20:20, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, no matter what you see coming, no matter what you hear. Don't be afraid. There's a lot of reasons in the world. In fact, the Bible says, as we approach closer to the coming of the Lord, men's hearts will begin to fail them from fear. Men's hearts will stop beating because they're so afraid. Seeing the things coming on the earth, but God's people are not afraid. Yet those who are not afraid. 2 Chronicles 20:20-21. Believe in the Lord your God and put his name from the last day standing for you. Put your foot down. Sometimes it's time to put your foot down. And I never put your foot down again. That's it. Believe in the Lord your God and you will stand for you. Believe in the prophets and you will succeed. Believe the word of God. Believe his prophets. And you'll be blessed. Hang on to every word I speak to you. As long as it's from the word of God, and you're going to prosper. You're going to succeed. You're not just going to survive. You're going to thrive. So we did talk about a 2020 vision for a prophetic new year. It's time for clear, solid vision. It's time to see possibilities instead of problems. It's time to see God's glory and God's name exalted. Paul was told, when he was still Saul, he was told, time to open their eyes, to open their eyes, to open their eyes, that they may turn from darkness to light and to the power of Satan to God. Then there will be forgiveness for their sins and to give a place among God's people who are set apart by faith in the year. All starts by having your eyes open. You've got to see properly. You have to pray to the Lord, oh Lord, I pray, open his eyes, you may see, and the Lord open his servant's eyes, he couldn't see before his eyes were open. And his son, behold, a mountain that's full of horses and chariots of fire all around him. In other words, no matter what your problem, you've got to see God's presence. No matter what the threat, you've got to see God's presence. No matter what the issue is, you've got to see that God is with you. What you see when you look around you. Do you see the enemy? Do you see pain? Do you see problems? Or do you see the presence of God? The Spirit of God to see through the fog of fear and to see the glory of God.
It takes faith. I said it takes faith to lift your eyes off of Goliath and see the God that is bigger than any giant in your life. So this year, we're going to see the power of God manifested. We're going to see the glory of God revealed. But we've got to get a stop set. We've got to get an eye check. Jesus said, he says in Revelation chapter 3, verse 18, you don't know what God's doing in your blood. You don't know what it's like to see. When you're deceived, you don't know what the truth is. You don't know that it's wretched and miserable and poor and black and naked. You don't have an idea how sad your situation is. You don't know that you're wretched and miserable and poor and black and naked. I counsel you. I think that's a good counsel. I thank God for giving us the greatest counselor in the human world has ever known is Jesus Christ. And he says, I counsel you to buy gold from your gold to what's right by fire, then you'll be rich. Buy white garments from me so you'll not be seen by your nakedness, and ointment for your eyes so you'll be able to see. I correct and discipline everyone I love, so be diligent and turn from your indifference. That was the blindness. That was the nakedness. That was the poverty. That was the wretchedness in the world. What difference does it make? I'm okay. You're okay. If you're indifferent, you're far from God. Jesus said, look forward to the Spirit of the Lord that was upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recover the sight to the blind. We can see. We can see again. Somebody said, glory to God. To set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to proclaim that the time of the Lord's favor has come. How do we get back? How does our vision get blown? How does our vision get destroyed? A spirit of condemnation and judgment to be back. And what Jesus told us, a hilarious story of someone trying to help a friend who is expecting an old man with a log sticking up their arm. Because of the book, you'll cause more damage. You will hurt somebody you're trying to help. If a log out of your own eye can, you may be able to help somebody with a stick in their own eye too. Spiritual sight helps you see around you clearly. It helps you see above you that God is with us, God is here. It helps you see inside you and gives you self-awareness. You and I hear all three killing Christians and looking through binoculars all the time, spying on the neighbors. Wonder what's wrong with their eye, what's making, what's the other eye got you. No, we get to talk with God. Which compares to spend more time in front of a magnetized camera. God, examine my heart. Lord, help me see me. Self-awareness in this experience. More aware of your own needs don't come from God than you need to tell everybody their weaknesses. Self-awareness means being more aware of my own needs from God than my need to tell everybody about their weaknesses. It means taking personal responsibility my own spiritual maturity and growth. We read to you James 1, 22. If you listen to the word, don't obey. It's like drifting into sin to the other. You see yourself walk away and forget what you look like. But if you don't care for you, for the perfect law of liberty, that sets you free. If you do what it says, but I read the Bible, 7 chapters of the day. I get all the Psalms memorized. I can tell you what the Greek word means in every New Testament text. If you do what it says, I have 12 different translations of the Bible passage. If you do what it says, you know that I can sing most of the Psalms in melody and music. If you do what it says, do what it says, you've got to be able to write. God will bless you for giving yourself. You need to put away the binoculars. Stop staring at other people's eyes. Pick up the mirror of God's word and ask for self-revelation, self-examination, and pick up a telescope of prophetic beauty. I need to see God's word. I need to see the future. I need to see the glorious truth of Christ's point. I need to see the power of God prevail. I need to see the authority of the people through. I need to see the future of Jesus Christ. It's coming back again. Can you say amen? See it by God's faith. What is that clear about that vision for my God in 2020? I know I'm being repetitious. I'm also repeating. I know I'm being redundant. I know I'm going over this again. Because did you know that an old drug comes to the past touch anything? He's got a child 4 times. I don't want you to raise an old girl's life. A lot of people are not here next week. There are many people who are not here next week. Jobs, illness, vacation, employment, knowledge, just storm. It takes 4 times for a pastor, and that's just the people who come regularly, okay? So I'm not going to keep this all next week, but I'm going to keep it today because I want you to get this. I want this to be a part of your calendar. I want this to be part of your vision, part of your 2020. What is that clear prophetic vision for the God of 2020? You want to be clear, no obstructed vision, no foundation, no blindness, no distortion, and no double vision. What is double vision? It's double vision. Double vision is double. Double vision is double vision. Double vision means vision down. Who cares that means vision down? So we have one vision, simple, clear, it's plain. Our vision for 2026, people, power, and place. Stay with me. People, power, and place. Say it again. People, power, and place. We're going to love people more this year than ever did because people matter. Jesus died for people. People are going to know we care. People are why we're here. People who are lost and lonely. Clearly, people who need deliverance. People need hope. People that need Jesus. People have to be a part of our vision. Sitting on our table yesterday morning, praying over this, thinking about it, writing it, just contemplating, meditating, wanting to God, just thinking, oh Lord, and I'll help us to reach people in the home room. He said, I've talked to this place about once every 3 months or so. He's quite an email, he can call up and it's a pastor on a truck working at home. So what's wrong with me? He said, I've got my food stamps and I've got my time loaded up. I've got a Walmart and I'm a bus coming up to now. The wheel of my car broken out. I can't even lift these bags. Let's come and get me on this call. And I said, sure. And I'm getting the search bag. And I said, thank you.20 will face us new challenges, but we have the same old power. Somebody say, glory to God. Worship, talents, gifts, members, church attendance. Listen to me. If there ever was a time in your life when you had ever realized, I have come to the kingdom for such a time as this, it's now. It's a beautiful. Your life is prepared at this moment. Prepare times, exciting times. Whether you just this morning, if you didn't think about it, but you have this sneaking feeling, you have this suspicion that we're not in the 1950s anymore. Or 60s, or 70s, or 80s, or 90s. We're not in the office of the party, we're not watching every night planning for somehow when he's in the highest or comes back to life just before they die. That little husband friend is beautiful, but no one will ever want to live without that condition anymore. Nobody wants to live. You don't want that life to live yet. We might not have babies and horses, but I still want to tell you that you're going to do it. We're not in the 60s and 70s. We're not in the 90s or 2000s. You know that we now communicate more by texting than any other form of communication. More than phone calls, more than letters, more than postcards, more than Morse code. Not my Morse code. It's now 2020, and we're more than 10 years away from 2020, if you think about it. So much has happened in such a short period of time. We're more than a generation away from 2020. Just in the last 10 years, for crying out loud, the jobs won the World Series. And the Blues won the Stanley Cup. Donald Trump won the U.S. presidency. U.S. unemployment fell to 3.5%. And the United States has become the world's number one energy producer. It's time to leave the European Union and elect Boris Johnson as prime minister. Facebook is more valuable than General Electric, AT&T, and Citigroup combined. Just the last 10 years, most of us, like you and I, are interested, most of us trading our computers in for a single digital computer in our pocket. 2010 was the year the biggest apps began to appear. 2015, the U.S. Supreme Court allowed unrestricted access to same-sex marriage. In the last 10 years, our society has been completely confused and deceived about gender, about the meaning of a boy or a girl or a man or a woman or a male or female, gender fluidity and non-specificity is never seen as normal. The power of legendary Christian denominations in the U.S. has sided with the LGBTQ agenda and have no problem with demolishing the idea of a marriage between a man and a woman just in the last 10 years. Just in the last 10 years, one of the major political parties in the United States of America has decided to align themselves with Asians, Muslims, and socialists, defining everything that America wants to do for them. Just in the last 10 years, now, it takes some thinking to wrap your mind around this because it's unbelievable what's happened. In the last 10 years, our world and our culture has become absolutely confused and deceived about drug use. Listen, you've got to wrap your mind around it. In the same period, an opioid epidemic is killing thousands of Americans every year. In the same period, politicians are deciding it's a good thing to make marijuana more available to people. It doesn't make sense. While the opioid epidemic continues to take thousands of lives, states like Illinois are rushing to legalize marijuana for recreational purposes. Now listen, they're afraid of our mind and their choice. I'm not talking about medical reasons and CBD. I have no opinion on that because I'm not a doctor, I'm not a medical professional. Somebody has to deserve it, will come to me online or in this house, and they will say to me, well, what do you think about it? How about it? I don't think about it. You know, you don't have to think about everything that you're qualified not to think about. I don't have an opinion on it. What does your must think? You know, all the chosen not to think about it. I'm not a doctor. That's between you and your doctor. What are you talking about? It's marijuana for recreational purposes. This is a stupid decision. It's an immoral decision. It's decisions like this that show us that wrong choices in the voting booth have consequences. We ignore the fact. We ignore the fact that marijuana is now 4 to 5 times more potent than it was in the 80s or the 90s. It's now more powerful, more addictive, and more dangerous. I agree. 2 weeks ago, that's been 2 weeks ago. It was so vivid, the dreams that I got, that I wrote down what I dreamed. I don't know why I was dreaming this, but I dreamt I was in a high school class, and there was a debate going on, and it was my turn to speak, and when I got to speak, I was charged to speak on what's wrong with marijuana. And I started asking these questions. And now I'm getting to my dream. This is how it was downloaded to me in my dream. This is what it says on the high school class. You would actually want more people on the road with impaired reflexes, reduced comprehension, and slower response. But people say, that's the legal. So is that the other? But still killed more than 10,000 people last year. Do we really want to pull up houses with less ability to say, to reason, to talk, to contemplate, and to solve problems? Colorado, the first state to legalize marijuana, leads the nation in use by 12 to 17 years old. The chances of drug dealers are killed in Colorado because their sales have skyrocketed, selling to minors and others at lower prices than dispensaries combined. Traffic accidents and fatalities, emergency room and treatment admissions, homelessness and other issues have skyrocketed in Colorado. Calls for poison control, suicide helplines have increased since legalization. Doctors, emergency room doctors, and mental health clinicians are creating new protocols and insurance codes to treat marijuana addiction and poisoning. And remember this, it is a gateway drug, because 95% of heroin and cocaine users report first using marijuana before they ever went on to something else. That's a form of it. It's natural, people will say. It's natural, God made it. Well, God made practices too. He doesn't intend you to kill harm. But I get such a euphoria that I need healing. So is stretching out her clip without a parachute that's not recommended. Someone said, I need the peace and the calm and the set of mind and the joy and the gift of Jesus. All drugs are a gateway drug. And gateway is just something experience something much more powerful and demonic about this opposite to the liberal view. Drugs do that. And open the mind and the soul to demonic oppression and evil spirits. Get a taste of that. The same Greek word in Revelation and Galatians translated sorcery, occult, that makes it sorcery. The same Greek word translated sorcery is actually pharmakeia, from which we get our word today, pharmacia, pharmaceuticals, drugs. God's word is telling us that sorcery and black magic and darkness and demonic realms and holy realms are often released through drug use. Because you just asked for that, maybe you're going to get 20%. Not all drugs are demonic, but the wrong drugs and the wrong use of drugs can open the door to the demonic world, and that's proven by Scripture. And it's proven by thousands of years of evidence. The most demonic powers I've ever seen were released in people's lives, and we have delivered, and we have convinced the deliverance to, because of their initial dabbling. So the church, what I'm telling you, we're going to have to learn how to fast and pray and minister deliverance more in the coming days that we're living. And we're going to be challenged. Is to speak the truth of life about every issue. We can get worked at. We can get angry, but we have to trust the Holy Spirit, help me every time I open my mouth to speak the truth of life about every issue. Because as you know, condemned people never attack people to Jesus. Angry, condemned people never. I ask the Holy Spirit every day when I pray, God, help me to let people know what I'm for more than what I'm against. I'm for people. I'm for the glory of God. I'm for freedom. I'm for love. Everybody can face them to some extent, praise God. On the other hand, compromising, serving people, afraid of the truth because they might offend somebody. They never brought anybody close to Jesus. I told you about me. don't believe in God. I don't believe in any of this stuff. Get out of my face.
We're going because it's about people. It's about power and prayer. Let's break it down.
They listen to the preacher. What I just read. They listen to the preacher and enjoy each other's company. They love hanging out with each other. They pray together. They say the blessing was over. They were told each other. They trusted and they prayed and they praised God. And the Lord started sending people daily and adding them to the church. Isn't that interesting? What a long way. If you think this one more time, you can tell me how I'm going to you. Well, I need to tell you what you're doing. You're doing something to save you. You're messing your Lord. You're rescuing. You're rescuing. So we'll pray it one time. And if there's anybody here that's a preacher, I want you to pray for me. I need the Word of God to bless you to stay around in 2020. Now that I'm over here, I'm going to be able to talk to you. So speak the anointing. The break every yoke in your life is really Jesus. You need blessing. Come on, let's pray.